Hi guys! Back in Shanghai. I'm going to Chicago in around 2 weeks. I'm back here to pack up, clean my stuff, make sure bring, you know, an adequate amount of clothes. A subscriber actually reached out to me on Instagram, had a good amount of questions about MUN for me. So I thought I would start off my MUN series with an FAQ video. MUN was a very large part in my common app. I was president of the International Affairs Association, aka MUN. I counted around 60 to 70 delegates ranging to MUNs from MIT, Harvard, Oxford MUN, and yeah. So I would say not, I think, like the best MUN person advice you could probably go to. If you have like an MUN counselor or, you know, MUN alumni, asking them might be a good idea. But I've trained a decent amount of people, and I also train people outside of my school as like a part-time job. I've been to 12 conferences in my life. 3 best delegates, 3 outstanding delegates, 2 like the equivalent of best delegate but for like the European conferences. Once I was Undersecretary General, once I was a Crisis Assistant Director, finally I was also the Secretary General for a conference held together with the actual UN. Anyhow, so I've been on the delegate side but also on the handing out awards side, which I think has provided me at least with really good insight as to how to do MUN. This is going to be a constant variable, by the way. So without further ado, how can I get myself recognized during committee session? There are so many delegates in one room and it's so hard to get recognized. The one way I think would be the easiest for you to stand out is amazing speeches. Now, we're talking about that like very loud opening that, you know, gets to the point, has that like gives that aura off of like no chatter, very business-like. But it can be anything. You can be humorous, you can be over the top. There was this Peruvian, 2 delegates who were super over the top, and they got BB in my committee. It was good and it was bad. It was like my favorite committee session ever, but you can feel my eye roll. So you can go completely over the top, you can be very business-like. Whatever it is, you have to be memorable. So I would say for your opening speech, and I don't mean like your topic agenda, like deciding topic A, topic B speech, just whichever speech that you are chosen first for, especially for a larger committee, you have no guarantee that when you raise your placard, you're going to get chosen. So just be prepared. Whichever time you speak first has to ring loud and clear what country you're from and give off that aura. So just in short, great speeches, especially opening speeches, and consistently raising our placard, asking good questions, recognizing delegates for the work that they do. In reference to this country's previous point, that shows that 1, you're paying attention, 2, that country's now paying attention, and 3, afterwards you can reach out to that country and you can either establish an ally or like a friendly relationship. Don't make enemies that fast. All right, 2nd, what kind of delegates do you think win best delegate? The one who does a lot of research, or the one who argues, or the one who authors resolutions, etc. So a lot of these are not mutually exclusive. I would say the ones that win BD are usually block leaders, first or second in command of their block. And I think their block, safe to say, has to be at least, I would say, top 3 largest blocks or 3 most powerful blocks. But again, this really depends. For Wyman, Yale MUN in New Haven, when I went there, I wasn't a block leader. I was in 10th grade, so I was like really young compared to the others. I remember there was this Hotchkiss group. There were like 3 Hotchkiss people there, and they were all like seniors, and one was going to Duke, and one was going to Columbia, and I was like, sophomore. Anyhow, I ended up getting BD, and I wasn't a block leader, but for that one, I focused a lot more on really, really pointed research and really crafted solutions, so that's how I won that one. But most of my BDs, or most of my awards, I think, are geared towards like larger, more American conferences, because as you know, Wyman is hybrid European procedure. So I think the delegates that win BD, best delegate, are block leaders, as I mentioned before. They have a strong presence in committee, but not in the sense of arguing. I know there are a lot of delegates who are very alpha, who, you know, go up there, oh, you want to talk to this country, please come and do it. I don't like. Maybe they do in BD, but I think if there is a better alpha delegate who is, you know, more generous, more caring, more, you know, like establishes connections with your countries, that delegate will win out. Yeah. But it also means that you have to show the chair that side of you, because it's very easy to be just hidden in the background. Doing a lot of research is your threshold. You want to go for BD, doing a lot of research is your basis. I know there are people who don't do any research and get BD. You can strive to be those people, but since, you know, you're trying hard anyways, just do your research. There's no other way to prep for MUN anyways. You know, people are like, oh, cologne and making up. Sure, that's like the fun part of it, but your groundwork is your research. Get your research together and then start thinking about your speeches and your presence and your, you know, appearance and all of that. 3, under what category should I do research? how much is enough. I think that when you do research, 10% maybe goes to the topic, another 20 to 30% on your country and the topic, specifically in your region or just like that topic, recent development or recent news, and then a huge like 60% chunk devoted to solutions. What solutions have worked in the past, what haven't worked in the past, devise your own solutions, devise a set of solutions, come up with an approach that links your solutions together, things like that. I feel like that should take up most of your research. I create two standard research documents. I'm a meticulous planner, so there's a very specific way in which I would do my research in. I can go over it if you guys want me to. Let me know if you want me to go over my research method and maybe share my research template. But basically, I make two research documents. They are maybe 8 to 9 pages long each. Under what category should you do research? So I think there are two major categories. Of course, there are infinite numbers, but to me, there are two major ones. One is you organize your solutions by the problem. This problem, this solution, this problem, this solution. Or you organize your solutions by the solutions. Economic solutions, solutions that don't require funding, solutions that are more administrative, solutions whatever. So the difference is, I have a problem, I want to solve a specific problem, and then I have these solutions to solve this problem. Or I have this one solution, and then this one solution targets many different areas. Yeah. So just two ways to kind of organize your research. That's how I would organize it. I prefer the latter, but honestly, you could do either. Advice to delegates who are contesting against other very experienced delegates. It's difficult because MUN is all about experience. If you got it, you got it. If you don't know much about MUN, then you know, take the opportunity to learn. I would say if you are really inexperienced, if you want to gun for awards, go to smaller committees. ECOSOC, regional bodies, specialized agencies, then your research is going to matter a lot more, maybe, than your lobbying skills, because it's going to be a lot more content focused, which is usually easier to ease into than, you know, a lot of like networking and lobbying techniques, which is required in General Assembly. If you're in a GA and you're a newbie and you want to win, which was me in the beginning, my number one advice to you would be to grounding your research, making your smaller block, and then recruiting a lot of people. Find a very specific direction for you. There are many different types of blocks. There's like the power block, the block of people who don't really care, middle party block, or regional blocks, or et cetera, et cetera. I think it's always good for you to start out with your own weaker block and then start recruiting more. And then once you have the numbers, and then you can start, you know, considering whether you want to merge with the stronger delegate power blocks. How do I come up with points of information that are savage on the spot? I don't really use points of information that much, to be entirely honest, but I really love... The delegate previously has said A, but I noticed in your clause 4, subclause B, subclause 3, that you instead said this. May the delegate please elaborate on this discrepancy?
Savage.
You have like a powerful, imposing persona in committee. Doing that might make you annoying, but if you have like a more friendly, sincere, but still powerful, which is what I try to go for, then you might be able to get away with something like that. You might get a couple of woos, and the chair will at least be okay, eye for detail, or the chair might hate it, depends on your chair. During resolutions, should I form a block with other strong delegates in which I would speak less, or form a block of my own, which is weaker delegates? Weaker delegates. And I try to go for many, 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 many weaker delegates. If there's a block with a lot of strong delegates, first of all, DR sponsors, good luck sorting out 5 DR sponsors. It's going to take forever. You need the numbers more so than you need the active people. I would say you need 1 to 2 very, you know, forthcoming speaking delegates who need core allies in a big conference. And once you have the numbers, then you can leverage and then merge with the larger, louder egos in the power block. Yeah, that's what I like to do. You try to become the largest block objectively, and people want to get your numbers, right? Get your votes. And so they're going to come to you, and then you can negotiate on your terms. I want 3 out of the 5 sponsor seats. Why? Because I have 60 people and you have like 30. I'll be at 30 outspoken people, but I have 60. Many times, at least where I live, the chairs and co-chairs tend to favor their friends or allow them to speak more. So how do I tactfully tackle that? Tactfully, good word. Speak to your counselor if it really gets out of hand. The administration will have these meetings where they talk to the counselors and ask for feedback. And, you know, just say that, oh, my delegates, like tell your counselor you haven't been able to speak, even raise your placard like a dozen times. What it is going to do though is make the chair slightly more aware of your situation, and then keep raising your placard. Just keep doing it. If they still don't pick on you and choose to speak with your friends, then try to lobby your way. Look, listen, MUN is extremely unfair, okay? I've been through a shit ton of situations. Unfair things always happen. Maybe they're not actually unfair. Maybe it's just in our eyes as delegates and in as an assistant director's eyes, maybe they might be unfair as well. But ultimately, it doesn't matter because if it's unfair, there's nothing you can do to change it. If they really are set on favoring people from their own school, they're gonna do it. There's nothing you can tactfully do to make them stop. Don't try to call them out on it. You know, don't be like the nitpicky snitch person that, you know, like rats on the chair, because you don't have proof of it. So don't bother. So just know it in your mind. And then try your best anyways. Regardless of it, just try your best. I always pretend it's not there, because if I think it's there, it's an excuse for me to like excuse myself. Like, oh, you didn't do that well this time because the chair obviously favored their own delegate. Don't do that. It breeds a very dangerous mindset, and is that there's nothing I can do to change the situation, and it's just not a productive mindset for pushing yourself further as an MUN delegate. Any tips slash advice you can give for delegates from your own experience? I could go on for hours, my girl. But my number one would be to know what kind of persona you are and stick to it. You don't have to be like the loudest, most like imposing delegate to win. In fact, I am not. I try not to be. There are many types of power delegates. I'm not an alpha, but I am an alpha delegate, or I try to be an alpha delegate. But my point is there are many different types. Know your style. Try out a couple of styles. Don't try to be the delegate that you're not. I've seen people who are very calm, pointed delegates who end up getting DD as well. So honestly, it's just up to the way you play the game. That's why I like MUN so much. There's so many, and there's an infinite number of ways for you to win, because there's no formula for it. Instead of debate, where, you know, better points, better argument, better practice speeches, better like speed of talking, all of these are little advantages. All of these may help in MUN, or they may not. You never know. It's so unvariable, and I think it's fun. MUN is really fun. So let me know your, you know, pet peeves or what you think about the questions I've answered, things like that. Yeah. If you found it useful at all, please subscribe. We would both appreciate it, wouldn't we? Where's your, oh, there. We would both appreciate it. If you like this video, check out my other videos, leave a comment, share it with your friends. I'm trying to grow my channel before I'm too busy dying in New Chicago. So, yeah.